Hello friends, this is Dr. Shilpa Gavande, once again here with one more topic, that is IV compartment open model. In that we will discuss today intravenous bolus administration. Now before going that, we have an idea. In the last lecture we have studied about the compartment models, what are the types of the different type models. Now in this case, one compartment model, you can see here in this picture. Now this, before administration the body is like this, and after administration the complete drug is going to distribute throughout the body immediately after the administration in case of the one compartment model. Now if we take the more two compartments, like here, that is plasma, one compartment it is the plasma, blood, heart, kidney and liver, and another it is the tissue and the bone skin. Now you can see here. See, if more than one compartments are there, before administration the body is like this, and after, immediately after administration, the drug distributes here in this area only, that is the heart, lungs and kidney. But after some time the body, the drug is going to distribute throughout the body in case of the more than one compartment. So it takes time compared to the one compartment model to get drug distribute throughout the body. Now you can see here. Now we know that the assumptions of the one compartment model, it is actually, it is the simplest method on the model to get understand the distribution of the drug. And owing the simplicity, the it is actually, this one compartment model, it is based on the assumption, certain assumptions, that the body, it is in this one compartment model, our body, it is considered as a single kinetically homogeneous unit that has no barriers to the movement of the drug. This assumption is there, okay? The body, it is a single one and there are no any barrier in the movement of the drug. Then final distribution equilibrium between the drug in plasma and other body fluid is attained instantaneously and maintained all the times. It is assumed that key, the equilibrium between the drug, plasma and the body fluid, it is instantaneous, it is very fast, and it maintained at all the time. And this model actually thus applies only to the drug, those drugs that distribute rapidly throughout the body. So in this case, in case of the one compartment model, the drug is going to be, it is assumed that drug is going to be fastly distributed throughout the body, and the final distribution equilibrium, it is uniform at all the time. Then next assumption, it is that drug moves dynamically in and out. In, it means absorption, and out, it means elimination of this compartment. From the single compartment only the drug is going to absorb and the drug is going to eliminate. Elimination, it follows the first order process, that is the mono exponential. We know that the first order process, it is the mono exponential process. So this elimination, it follows the first order kinetics with the first order rate constant, with the first order rate constant. Now see, the next assumption, it is that the rate of input is always greater than the rate of output. And here the anatomical reference compartment in which we are going to administer the drug, it is the plasma, and the concentration of the drug in the plasma, it's representative of drug concentration in all body tissue. The concentration which is present in the plasma, that is equal to the concentration which is present in the complete body tissues. Any change in plasma drug concentration, if there is any change in the plasma drug concentration, it reflects that much proportional change in the concentration of the plasma tissue also. It means the concentration in the plasma will be similar to the concentration, or it will be directly proportional to the concentration of the drug in the body also. But this model, it does not assume that the drug concentration in the plasma is equal to that of the other body tissue. This is not the assumption. It is directly proportional, or in proportionality there will be change in the plasma concentration and the body drug concentration, but it is not, this model does not assume that they both the concentrations are equal. They may be proportional, but they are not equal. Now you can see here, this is the one compartment. From this compartment drug it gets in, and from the same compartment the drug is going to be eliminated also. So drug in means absorption of the drug. From the same compartment we are getting the drug out, that is elimination. And if you plot a graph, that is concentration versus time, we can get a linear curve. You can see here the linear curve we are getting here. That means the it follows the first order kinetics. Now see here, this is what we can say, a diagram which represents the term. Now why it is called as the open one? This open, it means that the input and the output both are unidirectional, means the absorption of the drug and elimination of the drug, it is unidirectional, in the same direction both are following. You can see in this diagram, that is the input is in this direction and output is also in the same direction, and that drug can be eliminated from the body. From the drug, the direction in which the drug is going to absorb, in the same direction the drug is going to excrete also. One compartment open model, it is generally used. It is generally used to describe the plasma levels. Plasma levels ko describe karne ke liye this open model it is used. Following the administration of a drug, following the administration of a single dose of a drug, a single dose, if you are getting a administering a single dose, to understand that, to describe that the plasma levels, to describe the plasma level of the drug, this one compartment model it is generally used. Now if we can see different types of the one compartment models here, depending upon the rate of input, what is the rate of input, depend on the basis of that rate of input, these compartment models, there are four types of the compartment model. You can see here one compartment model, that is one compartment open model IV bolus administration, one compartment open model continuous IV infusion, one compartment open model extravascular administration, zero, which follows the zero order absorption, and one compartment open model extravascular administration which follows the first order absorption. So these are the four, you can see the models, these types of the one compartment open models. Now we'll discuss in one compartment open model, that is the intravenous bolus administration. It is very useful model, and also in the examination which is in the PCI pattern, there may be a 10 mark question asked, long answer question may be asked on this topic. It is very important topic from the examination point of view also, and is very basic one also. So when drug that distributes rapidly in the body, see here in bolus administration what happens, bolus means what, ki we are going to distribute the drug rapidly in the body in a given form of a rapid intravenous injection. We are administering the drug in the form of a rapid intravenous injection. It takes about 1 to 3 minutes, just you can imagine, it takes about only 1 to 3 minutes for complete circulation of the drug throughout the body. So you can imagine ki only 1 to 3 minutes of the drug it is required for the complete circulation, and therefore you can see in this diagram there is no rate of absorption. We have not given the rate of absorption in this diagram. Therefore the rate of absorption, why we have not given, because as it is going to take only 1 to 3 minutes, so that rate of absorption is going to neglect. It is neglected in the calculation, and this model, it is given by this IV bolus, it is given, it is represented by this diagram. You can see here, this is the one compartment, that is blood and the other body tissues, and only an elimination constant it is given. Got it? Now see, this is the general expression for the rate of absorption. We know that in the last lecture we have studied about, that is the general expression of the rate of drug. We know that dx upon dt is equal to rate in, that is the availability minus the rate out, that is the elimination. We numbered this equation as 1.1. Since the rate in and or absorption, it is absent. Now we know it takes just only 1 to 3 minutes. So here rate of absorption we have not considered in this IV bolus. So this equation will become dx upon dt is equal to minus rate out. Got it? The rate out or the elimination, it follows the first order kinetics. We know that the first order kinetics, and we have formula for the first order kinetics, that is the dx upon dt is equal to minus kex. We have studied it in the first order kinetics. If you follow the my third lecture, in that third lecture I have explained you what is the first order kinetics. Now here, what is ke? It is nothing but the first order elimination rate constant. X, it is the amount of the drug in the body at time t. At time t, amount of the drug in the body remaining to be eliminated. This much amount of the drug, it is remaining to be eliminated. And what is, what negative, this negative sign, what it indicates? This negative sign indicates that the drug is going to, it is being lost from the body. The drug, it is going to be lost from the body. Now see here, from this IV bolus administration we can estimate the some pharmacokinetic parameters, and there are four pharmacokinetic parameters which we can determine or estimate from this equation. That is, for a drug that follows the one compartment kinetics administered as a rapid IV injection. Now you can see here, these are the four parameters. Now it is going to that drug, when we administer it, gets, it is going to it will distribute first and then it will comes in the elimination phase. So plasma drug concentration is only due to elimination of the drug. The there is decrease in the concentration of the drug due to the elimination of that drug in the body, and not due to the distribution and distribution phase. And that drug that is called as the elimination phase. Now see here, there are four parameters in that elimination phase. That is the elimination rate constant, that is Ke, apparent volume of distribution, that is Vd, elimination half life, and the clearance. These four parameters we can determine by the equation. Now see, first we'll study about the elimination rate constant. Now what is elimination rate constant? Elimination rate constant represents the fraction of the drug removed per unit time. In unit time, how much quantity of the drug is going to be removed. And here K has unit of reciprocal of time. It has a unit of reciprocal of time, that is the minute inverse. If it is in the minute, then minute inverse will be the unit. If it is in the hour, then hour inverse is the unit. And if it is in a day, then day inverse. It is the unit of this elimination rate constant. Now with first order elimination, the rate of elimination, now as we know the first order process, that first order process, it is directly proportional to the concentration of the drug in the plasma. So this first order elimination, it is the rate of elimination is directly proportional to the serum drug concentration. It is directly proportional to the serum drug concentration. Now you can see the equation. This is the equation. The equation for the elimination rate constant, we have dx upon dt is equal to minus ke upon x. This is the equation. Now if we integrate this equation to the base natural log, to the base natural log, then we get, that is the log of x is equal to log of x0. x0, it is the initial concentration of the drug, minus ket. Ke, it is the elimination rate constant, t is the time. So x0, it is the amount of drug at time 0, and x is the concentration at time t. Now you can see here, this equation, if we integrate this to then we get this to the best 10. If we are going to integrate it, if you can see that this is in the mono exponential format. This equation, it is in the mono exponential format, and we know that the first order equation, it is mono exponential. So you can see here x is equal to x0 e raised to minus ket. This is what the elimination rate constant. Now see here, this equation, the above equation, we can write it on to the base 10, log to the base 10, we can write it. We get this equation, that is a log of x is equal to log of x0 minus ket upon 2.303. This is the equation for the elimination rate constant. And from this equation, we can calculate the elimination rate constant by using the IV bolus. Now, it is very difficult to determine the direct amount of the drug in the body. Key, how much concentration of the drug it is in the directly in the body. So we can take the one more equation to get the idea about the concentration of the drug in the plasma, that is C and X. So we get this equation, that is we know that volume of apparent volume of distribution VD is equal to exponent C. This equation is there, and from that equation we can calculate the quantity of the X, so amount of the drug in the body. So this X is equal to VD into C, that is the X is equal to apparent volume of distribution into the concentration. So VD, it is the proportionality constant. In this equation it is proportionality constant, but popularly it is known as the apparent volume of distribution. Now see, this is the graph for the IV bolus equation, that is the one compartment open model IV bolus. And this, if we take the concentration versus time, this graph, it will give you, this is the regular plot, we can say it as a Cartesian plot, and this is a semi-logarithmic plot. Now here we can say that key concentration log of C, it is directly proportional to the time. It is directly proportional to the time, and there is a linear equation, linear what we can say, relationship. Now see, we should know about what is the apparent volume of distribution, what is the basic of apparent volume of distribution. Now see, I have shown you the two containers here. Now in one container 100 liter of the solution is liquid is there, and in one container only 10 liter it is there. And if we dissolve 100 milligram of the drug in both the containers, now see, you can see here there are no particles, because the concentration will be 1 milligram per liter, and here the concentration it is 10 milligram per liter. So we get the, what we can say, the particles here. So concentration will be 10 milligrams per liter. So what is apparent volume of distribution? It is the hypothetical volume of the body fluid into which the drug is going to be distributed. This is a, what we can say, concise definition, or we can say meaning of the apparent volume of distribution, that is the amount of the drug it is going to be, what we can say, distribute in the body. So we know the formula for that, that is VD is equal to amount of the drug in the body divided by the plasma drug concentration, and it is expressed in liters. The this apparent volume of distribution, it is expressed in liters. So we can get the apparent volume of the distribution also here by using this. Now see, the apparent volume of distribution, it represents the volume that must be considered in estimating the amount of the drug in the body from concentration of the drug found in the sampling compartment, right? Now in general, this drug equilibrates rapidly in the body. The drug is going to distribute and equilibrate rapidly in the body when plasma and any other biological compartment is sampled. If we are taking samples from the plasma or any biological compartment and it is going to be analyzed for the drug contained, the results generally jo report hote hai, the results which are reported in units of concentration instead of the amount. We get the reports in the unit of the concentration. We do not get ki how much amount of the drug is going to be distributed in that compartment, right? So it is necessary to calculate that amount. So it is in the form of a volume of distribution. So each individual tissue in the body, it may contain different concentration. In different tissue we get the different quantity of the amount, and therefore the amount given, and the amount of the drug given location, it can be related to the concentration by proportionality constant that reflects the volume of fluid in the drug which is dissolved. Now see this apparent volume of distribution. The drug which binds selectively to the plasma protein, generally if you see, this is the diagram. Actually this is the real volume of the distribution. It is the real volume of the distribution. It is related to the body water. Now see, total body water, it is 42 liters. If you see the concentration, that is the plasma volume is 4 liter. Interstitial fluid we have 10 liters and intracellular fluid we have 28 liters. So if you calculate, if you add these all, so total body will be the 42 liters. This is the real, what we can say, the volume of the distribution. Now what is apparent volume of distribution? Now the drugs like warfarin, which has a selectively binding capacity with the plasma proteins, if that binds with the plasma proteins, so in that case such drugs, they have smaller apparent volume of distribution compared to the real volume of distribution, because they are binding with the plasma proteins, right? And if we take the example of the chloroquine, which binds with the extravascular tissues, chloroquine agar lete hai, and that has a selective binding capacity with the extravascular tissues, so in that case the apparent volume of distribution will be the larger compared to the real volume of distribution. Matlab, wo 42 liters se bhi zyada aapko dikhega. So depending on the nature of the drug, the binding capacity of the drug, the binding nature of the drug, we get the different volume of distribution. May be smaller than the 42 liters or may be larger than the 42 liters of the total body fluid. Now these are the factors which affects the volume of distribution, that is the lipid solubility, degree of plasma protein, affinity for the different tissue proteins, then lean body mass and disease like congestive heart failure, uranemia or cirrhosis. Actually on an apparent volume of distribution, there may be a short note which asks generally for the 5 marks, write in short about the apparent volume of distribution. So this kind of the questions can be asked in the on the apparent volume of distribution. So we know that the formula of this apparent volume of distribution, that is the x upon c, that is the dose upon the initial concentration. This is the formula for the apparent volume of distribution. Now what is the significance of this apparent volume of distribution? Now see here the significance, it simply indicates ki the regarding the distribution of the drug in the tissues. Then second one, for example, jaise ki apparent volume of paracetamol, it is 0.95 liter per kg body weight. This is the distribution of this paracetamol. So 0.950 liters of tissue is expected to contain the same concentration of the paracetamol as that of in the blood on the basis of the average body weight. So if we can get from the value of the apparent volume of distribution ki how much quantity of the drug is going to contain in different parts. Now higher the apparent volume of distribution of the drug, more extensive in its is its distribution. It is more extensively distributed. If the plasma drug concentration is low, it can be inferred that the volume of distribution is higher for that given dose. If the volume of distribution is high, plasma drug concentration is low. If volume of distribution is small, then the drug concentration is more in the plasma and it is less distributed in the tissues. And if the volume of distribution is more, it is more distributed in the tissues. So if volume of distribution is 100% of the body weight, then we can assume that, or we may assume that the drug concentration in certain tissue compartments, that the drug concentration, that is 100% in the tissue compartments. If the drug is restricted to the vascular space and can freely penetrate erythrocytes, the drug has the volume of distribution of 6 liters. And also if the drug cannot permeate the RBCs, the available space is reduced to about 2-3 liters also. Now the next, this was about the apparent volume of the distribution. Then the next parameter from this IV bolus we can calculate, that is the elimination half-life. Now we know that कि व्हाट इज हाफ लाइफ, इट इज डिफाइंड एज द टाइम एट विच द मास और द अमाउंट ऑफ द ड्रग of unchanged drug it becomes half, that is to, it reduces to 50% of the initial mass. So T half we know that of the first order reaction, that is 0.693 upon K. Now increase the physiological understanding of the pharmacokinetic, it shows us the half life, it is a parameter that depends on the primary parameters clearance and apparent volume of distribution according to the following equation. Now see here, T half is equal to 0.693 into volume of distribution divided by the clearance, that is the total clearance CLT. Now the last parameter from this, it is the clearance. Now what is clearance? Clearance, it is the most important parameter in the clinical drug application and it is useful in evaluating the mechanism by which the drug is eliminated by the whole organism or by the particular organ. Now here we know that the clearance, it is the rate of elimination divided by the plasma drug concentration. Now in this case we can define the clearance, that it is a theoretical volume of a body fluid. It is what? It is a theoretical volume of the body fluid which contains the drug from which the drug is containing the drug and from which that drug is going to completely removed in a given period of a time. Now suppose the drug, it is present in body fluid and the volume, how much volume of that drug is going to eliminate it from the body, that is called as the clear in that particular period, that is known as the clearance. So it is nothing but the measure of the removal of the drug from the body. So plasma drug concentrations are affected by the rate at which the drug administered and the volume in which it distributes and its clearance. So a drug's clearance and the volume of distribution determine its half-life, because we know that half-life is equal to Vd upon clearance, we have seen in the last formula, right? 0.693 into Vd upon the clearance. So it is also, it is the most important parameter in the clinical drug application. This clearance, it is again important parameters. Now see here, what is the clearance? It describes the removal of the drug from the volume of plasma in a given unit time, that is the clearance. Clearance does not indicate the amount of drug being removed. It does not show you how much amount of the drug is going to be removed. But it indicates what? It indicates the volume of the plasma from which the drug is completely removed or cleared in a given period of a time. It doesn't give you the amount of drug, but it gives you the volume of the plasma or the blood from which the drug is going to be eliminated, right? So see here, in the following slides, I will give you two figures. The amount of the drug decreases but fills the same volume, resulting in the lower concentration. And another way, the viewing the same decrease would be to calculate the volume that would be drug free if the concentration were held constant. Now see, these are the two figures. The initial concentration is this and elimination after time will get the amount of the drug is going to be reduced. The volume is same but the concentration is decreased here. And see here, this is the initial concentration, elimination. Now here you can see the volume from which the drug is removed over time. This is the volume it is removed. So these two slides will give you the idea. Now in this case, what is clearance? We have defined the clearance, that is, it is a hypothetical volume of blood and other of blood or other biological fluid from which the drug, it is totally and again it is irreversible. Yeah, this is important, that it is going to irreversibly eliminate or removed per unit time. So this is what a clearance, what we can say, ki one compartment pharmacokinetics clearance, this is the formula for the clearance, that is the K into Vd, clearance estimation, it is there. Now we know that the total clearance, it includes clearance from body in different pathways or in different organs, like hepatic clearance is there, renal clearance is there, biliary clearance is there, and sum of all this, it is called as the total clearance. So you can see CLT, it is the total clearance, it is nothing but the renal clearance plus hepatic clearance plus other clearance, other includes the other organisms. So total of this we can say it is the total clearance. And the elimination rate at any time, it can be calculated by using this, that is the K into XT, or elimination rate is equal to clearance into concentration at T. So this X, it is the total amount of the drug in the body at time T, and C, it is the concentration of the drug at time T. So this is about what we can say the different parameters which we calculate in the IV bolus. So this is about the one compartment IV bolus. So if it is asked in the examination, you have to give about these pharmacokinetic parameters also. You have to write along with the equation of the IV bolus, you have to write about the pharmacokinetic parameters which we can estimate from IV bolus equation. And if you like this video, please do like, share with your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.